A 45-year-old female comes in with a white mass on a panoramic radiograph. What's the next step? Part 2, the surgical removal and management of this lesion, today on the Open Reduction. Welcome to the Open Reduction, your channel, all things oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton, and today is part 2 of a radio-opaque mass in the left mandible. If you haven't yet, check out the part 1 video where I go over the clinical presentation and workup of this lesion. Quick refresher, we have a 45-year-old female with a slow-growing mass in her left mandible. She elected to undergo removal of this lesion in the office under IV sedation. I administer local anesthesia and then make an incision similar to what I would make for a third molar surgery. I elevate a full thickness mucoperiosteal flap and expose the underlying bone. Next, I use a round burr to uncover this lesion. I'm taking it slow because it might be hard to differentiate between healthy bone and this mass. I can see it coming into view, and now that I know what the consistency looks like, I can remove additional overlying bone. Once I feel like I've removed enough bone, I try to gently tease out this lesion. Just being a little stubborn. Now I'm able to move it slightly. And here it comes. I'm able to remove this lesion in one piece and the underlying bone looks healthy. I do a peripheral osteotomy and then irrigate the site thoroughly and then close it up. I get a nice primary closure and the wound is hemostatic. All of this tissue goes to the pathologist, and the report came back as a cementoblastoma. Cementoblastoma is a neoplasm of cementoblasts. These are rare growths. They represent less than 1% of odontogenic tumors. They are more common in the mandible, and 90% of them are in the molar and premolar region. They can cause pain, but many, like this one, are asymptomatic. Cementoblastomas can cause cortical expansion and perforation of the cortex. This lesion most likely was associated with the root structure of tooth number 17. When the tooth was removed years ago, the cementoblastoma was left behind and continued to grow slowly. The treatment is complete removal along with a peripheral ostectomy. The recurrence rate is extremely low if the lesion is removed in its entirety. Thanks so much for watching. Please check out my channel for other interesting OMFS cases like this one. Hit those like and subscribe buttons. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton. I'll catch you next time on the Open Reduction.